So with 5:59, Carmel will look to put it in play. They trail 21-14.
Well, Mahopac has excellent field position to save the game for themselves. What they have to do is take McAloon out of the ball game, which maybe with going to the zone, they can give some help over there to Hart or whomever McAloon lines up on.
And Don, the good thing about having 5 minutes and 58 seconds on the clock, you can pretty much run your normal offense. There's plenty of time for Carmel to move the ball down the field. They're not in a hurry-up situation just yet.
McAloon and Rosario both to the right. Heitman back to throw.
Heitman intended for Constantinides. Good coverage downfield. That would have been close to a first down. It'll be second and 10.
Yeah, that was nice move by Eric Cheek to be 12 yards deep there. And he did a nice job. It was a good hit. And the Cheeks have always been known as hitters.
That's right. Eric had a brother that could apply the pads, Charlie Cheek. Last year, Eric started in the defensive backfield. This year, moved to linebacker. He's number 32.
Again, Compton, I think Mahopac's got the upper hand here with the changing of their defense to a zone rather than man-to-man.
Second and 10 for Carmel from their own 13.
Here we go, the ball on 13, second and 10. Again, Heitman to put it up. And this is complete, and it's for a first down. And that's number 85.
Rich Parisi on the reception.
Rich Parisi in on the reception. That is his first reception. And a lot of good things were expected from Rich Parisi, but that's his first catch this evening.
Captain, I like Mahopac's defense. Even though they gave up the short one, they were deeper than the ball. They against Suffren, too many times the backs were even with the offensive end. Here they're deeper than they are, so they're not going to give up the long one, and that's important right now.
19-yard reception by Parisi.
Heitman back to throw.
Heitman, this is complete to McAloon, and he gets 5, maybe 6.
McAloon,
as he had to get out to the 42 to get a first down, so he's going to be a yard or so shy of the first down.
They're running a two-minute offensive drill here with the shotgun, and it's a good move on their part because they really need to do this.
Heitman again, same play to McAloon for the first down, and McAloon fights to get to the midfield marker.
A good play calling by Carmel, but I think also good defense by Mahopac. It's going to be whether one of these balls doesn't bounce off one of these ends and end up on the Mahopac end, or whether they go in for the score.
Frank Heitman showing his ability on this drive.
Back to throw.
Great pass completed to LeSavio. It breaks the tackle. First down over the 40, down to the 35. And that was a nifty job by Dave LeSavio. And he was showing signs of Joe Natalie.
Yeah, they're two wonderful ball players, no question about it. Natalie may be a little more versatile, but who is in his class anyway?
Carmel coaching staff paid the ultimate compliment to Frank Heitman, said he has the respect of all his teammates, and we can certainly see why. This is McAloon. And McAloon, having a terrific game, gets down close to the 22-yard line. Jim McAloon, number 11, has really been the key man for Carmel.
Well, I've said it all ball game, Compton. Mahopac's playing man on man. They've got to put a man and a half out there. This is down here. They've got to go in for the score. Carmel does. Why not play a man and a half out on them?
Scoreboard clock shows 4 minutes and 8 seconds. Carmel 7-0, Mahopac tied it. Carmel led 14-7, Mahopac tied it, and Mahopac has gone ahead 21-14, and that's where we stand. Heitman, and a wide open receiver downfield, and Heitman had gotten behind the coverage. Vin Vaccarello came over to help out, but that pass was just over the outstretched hands of Nick Constantinides.
I've got to go back to McAloon. They ran a pick play over here. Both kids were open, and I wouldn't want to throw in Vinny's direction. Vinny had three interceptions last week.
Second and 10, the ball on the 23-yard line, and we're in four down territory right here. Heitman barks out directions, and he's going to run it. Looking to get outside. He has one player to beat, and he does that and skips down the sidelines. Good job by Frank Heitman. We mentioned he had over 100 yards rushing coming into tonight's contest, and he slipped outside, and a good job. He's an all-around athlete.
He's had an impressive game, Compton. Very impressive.
They're going to spot the ball at about the 14-yard line.
Mike Mackey was saying that he's learned a lot from Frank Heitman this year. Again, Mackey was the defensive coordinator the last several years for Carmel. Nick Fletcher handled the offense. And Coach Mackey said he's really enjoyed working with Frank Heitman. And we have the 4 minute stop of the clock right here, 3 minutes and 52 seconds showing. Mahopac clinging to a 21-14 lead, and Don, this game has been everything that we expected.
Oh, a magnificent game, one that will go down the memory bank. Couldn't ask for anything more, and it's far from over. Should Carmel score here, or are you going to go for one or two, Compton?
You know, I was thinking about that a couple plays ago. That's why I'm up here, not down there, right? Third down and two, ball on the 14. Carmel has to get it down to the 12 for a first down.
Captain, Mackey's dilemma is going to be if they do score, you've got Constantinides, who's a superstar, and you've got a kicker who hasn't missed yet. That's some decision.
And this is Madigan. And a second effort by Madigan. And he's got the first down. He's brought the ball all the way down to the 10. He has played awfully well as well this evening. He's number 36. And you know, when you get into these big games, it's the captains that have to come through. And for Carmel, that's Frank Heitman and Brian Madigan.
Well, actually, you have six of them, Compton, and their center is doing a heck of a job as well. He's giving him, Feliciano's giving him good leadership as well.
We're going to talk to several of these players after the game, and we are going to get the center, Tom Feliciato. And this is Oregon, and Oregon spins for a couple. He gets down near the five. And Don, I got to tell you, I'm the kind of guy, I said this a few years ago when Carmel was in the bowl game and went for the 2 points. I kicked the 1 point tie. But I suspect that Mike Mackey will go for the 2 point conversion.
Well, it's a heck of a decision. I think number one, I kicked the go for the point and the tie, and you're still number one.
These teams are tied for number one, and I got to believe a tie would also mean another meeting later on. Heitman, and what a play as Heitman is tackled all the way back on the 20-yard line. He is ruled down.
Heck of a play for Mahopac, a really big play for Mahopac. The quarterback was ruled in the grasp and down, so the fumble wouldn't count. But now this gives Mahopac a shot still at victory here. I also think, Compton, that Mahopac went into the goal line defense. That threw Carmel off a little bit.
Gerard Lichtenberger along with Perricone and Caparelli in on that big sack, and Heitman on a third down play. And he's going to run. He's got some daylight in front. And he's down near the 10-yard line. Still going to be shy of a first down. It is going to set up a fourth. And we're going to call it maybe six.
Compton, here's the ball game, right? If Carmel doesn't make it, I think they only have two timeouts left.
Well, it's going to be fourth and eight. 1 minute and 38 seconds to go. And Carmel Carmel's going to take a timeout to think things over. It doesn't get any more exciting than this. Carmel has won.
Hi, I'm Rudy Giuliani. I've known Bob Ravallo for 30 years. Bob is making Carmel the best it can be. Bob has always been his own man. He's a fiscal conservative, but he's also fought hard to protect the environment and the rights of seniors. Bob cares about people and wants to continue to serve you. On Election Day, re-elect my friend Bob Ravallo.
Thanks, Rudy. I'm Bob Ravallo. I need your help to continue working for you, the residents of Carmel and Mahopac. Please vote for me on November 5th.
Well, we're back. And this is a 4th and 9. A good job by Paul Rochford, getting us back right in the nick of time. And this is the ball game, folks. 1:37 to go, 4th and 8. Heitman going to look towards the end zone. All open is McAloon. Touchdown. Jim McAloon, who has done it all evening, comes up with the tying or potential tying touchdown reception. And salutes to Frank Heitman. What a pro.
Well, not only Heitman, McAloon ran a wonderful post pattern, and he went right for the flag there, rather, and left the Mahopac defensive player really standing still. He was open by a good 10 yards, so all Heitman had to do was get on the pass. It was really a wonderful pass route by the young man who was going to give him a chance for the tie.
Absolutely extraordinary, and the score right now is 21-20. And you know who predicted that score in the paper today? Our county executive, Bob Bondi. He said Mahopac was going to win 21-20. Well, that's where we stand right now. 1:31 to go in this game, and there have been so many stars here this evening. I can't even begin to select who we're going to talk to after the game.
Just a marvelous, marvelous football game. Now, Compton, are you going to go for the one? And if you go for the one, are you going to do an onside kick if you're successful? Are you going to do an onside kick if you're successful?
Don, you're way ahead of me. I haven't even thought that far, but I'm sure Jerry Kevens and Mike Mackey have thought that far. I kick the extra point right here.
Definitely. It would be a fitting end to a marvelous football game. And then they'd have a chance in the bowl game to see who was the winner.
Exactly. But they're going to go for it. This is your game right here, an awful lot to ask for. Carmel's going to go for it. This is for the winner. Wide open, and it is complete, and it looks like Nick Constantinides on the far side of the field. Unbelievable.
And the game's not over yet, Compton. Don't forget, Mahopac has a very fine kicking game in terms of receiving. They can get good field position. You've got three timeouts left, so it's not over yet. But Carmel deserves a tremendous amount of credit for having the guts to go for that. I wouldn't have done it personally. They did it. They were successful. They went to their stud. It worked out for them. We still have time left, though.
Well, I'm sure the Carmel players are going... Those C-Tech announcers are wimpy. They went right for it. All the credit in the world to the Carmel football team and Mike Mackey. And with 1:31, Carmel has gone out on top 22-21. It couldn't be any closer.
And took an awful lot of courage to do that, but they did have a nice pattern. He was wide open, and they were successful.
One thing about Carmel, they have those two huge receivers in Constantinides and McAloon, both go 6'3", and they tower over defensive backs, and opponents all season long have talked about that. Madigan puts his foot into it, a little bit short, taking on the 15. Natalie running far side, and he is hammered at the 25.
He got as much as he could out of it. Carmel had excellent coverage on that one, though.
Well, number 55 has been quiet, but that time he made his presence felt. And number 55 is Josh Mastrangelo. And he is certainly going to be an all-section player, possibly an all-state player. And he is looking to go big time. He's 55, and Carmel's going to drop way back right now with 1:14 to go. The ball just shy of the 25-yard line. Gordon's going to roll to his left. He's feeling the heat from Phil Feliciato, who chases Gordon out of bounds, and it's going to be second, and we'll call it 9. But most importantly, we're under the 1 minute mark.
But a wise decision by Gordon. Instead of throwing into traffic, he took it out of bounds. He's got a chance now to still have a big play. I like Lewis over here. He's still got one-on-one on the far outside here. He's got the wide side of the field to his side.
Just a reminder, this game is coming to you on tape delay, being played Monday and Wednesday evenings. We'll have election night coverage Tuesday night, right here on CTEC 8. Gordon, going to look downfield, feeling the heat. And he's going to run it once again. He's got the first down. He's going to look to the sidelines and heads out at the 40-yard line. Good job by Gordon.
Just picked up 15 more yards on unnecessary roughness, late hit, which is going to give Mahopac an even better chance at doing something, even a field goal.
That'll bring it into Carmel territory if that is the case. We'll wait and see. And Don, do you know who the long field goal kicker is for Mahopac?
Well, I'd have to think he's got to go with Zage because Joey Natalie's been running so much his legs have to be tired.
He told me that he would go with Natalie if they had a long field goal. Zage is a short field goal kicker as well as the extra pointer. But maybe you might be right. But he's got confidence in Natalie on a long field goal. We'll wait and see. But it would be apropos for Natalie to be the one to have to kick it. The ball is brought down to the 46-yard line into Carmel territory. 49 seconds show on the clock. Carmel 22, Mahopac 21. Gordon feeling the heat. Downfield. And Gordon did a great job just to get that ball off. Jack Scalise.
They're going to call the ball dead up back where Gordon was. I think they're going to call Gordon in the grass, which is a big play for Carmel. Gordon's shown his presence, though. I really am impressed. Got out of bounds those two times, turned around and threw the ball there to a receiver, a potential receiver. Wasn't throwing it into the Carmel hand, so that was a big play by Greg as well.
That front wall of Carmel has been strong throughout. And I said John Felice, I should have also said Tom Feliciato. He really applied a lot of pressure. 33 seconds to go. And what has been an extraordinary ball game. The two number one ranked teams in the four county area, Dutchess, Putnam, Westchester, and Rockland, right here. And Carmel leads 22-21.
And big break for Carmel. Natalie's coming limping off here. He got hit over there on the sidelines, and he's limping.
Bobby Torrey heads in 41. He had a long run earlier. And Don, at this particular point, with 39 seconds now, they reset the clock. Mahopac's going to have to throw the ball downfield.
Yeah, and they still have some burners in there in Maloney and Torrey, so they can go deep. And Gordon can get the ball to them if they give him the time.
Here's Gordon, and it is intercepted. The pass was intended for Frank Maloney. It's intercepted, and it is intercepted by number 56, Don Dingy. And Carmel's defense has done it, and Carmel will win 22-21.
Certainly looks that way, Compton. And they certainly, if anybody deserves to win, they certainly are right there. And we have a lot to look forward to for the rest of the season. It was a heck of a football game. I don't think the fans are giving everybody applause. And they all deserve applause. Carmel made a gutsy call, and they came away with a win.
Don Dingy, a junior, he's played so well this year. He and Mike Pellegrino, two juniors in that linebacking corps for Carmel, have performed well. And just like last week, it was a turnover that apparently is going to ice the game for Carmel. Last week, Mike DeBellis fell on a fumble, and that iced the win against North Rockland 7-6. And Carmel lets the clock run all the way down to 5 seconds, takes the penalty. And Frank Heitman is one kneel away from bringing Carmel to a 7-0 record. Carmel has a bye next week. We'll finish with Ketchum, and we saw several of Ketchum's scouts here this evening. Mahopac has their homecoming this Friday against FDR, and they'll finish on the road against Arlington, a game we anticipate doing. And that should do it. 3-2-1, it's over.
Let's give a lot of credit to the kids, too. They played so hard. They played so clean. That's what it was, just a marvelous, marvelous football game, and it was a privilege to be here, Constantine.
What a game. I've been doing this for an awful long time between radio and television. This is one of the best games that I've been associated with, and I'll certainly remember it for an awful long time. Our final from Mahopac High School, Carmel 22, Mahopac 21. Welcome back to Mahopac High School, where Carmel has just defeated Mahopac by the score of 22-21. And joining me first is Frank Heitman, the outstanding quarterback for Carmel. Oh, Jim McAloon, I'm sorry. I thought I had Frank here. Did we get Frank?
Frank's still talking to the other reporter.
Boy, I'm sorry. Well, listen, we'll get the other part in just one moment. But I'll tell you, what a terrific game, Jim. You really had to concentrate down the stretch. You made some big catches when it counted.
Well, we just went into our two-minute drill, and we always practice at every practice, so we're pretty good at it. And we got the chance to use it, and we were pretty effective.
Jim, it looks like you guys really didn't change too much with the leaving of Nick Fletcher. Just kind of went right along with the same old thing.
Yeah, we just took his program, you know, added a few max plays, and we're just trying really hard, you know. That's all we can do.
It looks like Coach Mackey has an awful lot of confidence in you as well as Frank Heitman.
Yeah, well, Mac, we wanted to run today because we're running good, but he likes to throw. We get our throwing done.
Okay, well, we got basketball season coming up, but we've got a big bowl game before that, and we're going to see a continued success.
Thank you.
All right, Jim McAloon on some terrific catches, and now Brian Madigan. And Brian, you had some big shoes to fill tonight with John Boyce going down with the injury.
Yeah, we dedicated, I guess, the rest of the season to John. He's like one of our best players, captain. So we just figured that we'd go out and win, like, the rest of our games for him.
And not only did you play outstanding in the secondary, two interceptions, what I was most impressed with was your foot. You can really put a boot in the ball.
Yeah, well, sometimes it's on, sometimes it's off. hopefully, thank God, it was on today.
I was really impressed with the Carmel rushing attack. Of course, we've heard a lot about both teams' passing ability. I think it was the key to the game that you were able to move the ball on the ground.
Yeah, well, once we got the lead, we started to try to run out the clock a little. You know, their offense, the high-powered offense that it is, we didn't want to give them as much time to score. So we lately our rushing game has been really well. So we just decided to stick with it.
Well, I'll tell you, you and Jeff Organ, terrific job. And I think that was the key to tonight's game.
Well, we've been working on a rushing game all week, past 3 weeks. Against FDR, we just opened it up, and North Rockland, we did better than we thought we would, and today was outstanding. Our offensive line owed all to them.
Well, keep it up. You're a great guy, and we'll
thanks
see you a little later on, all right?
All right, thanks
okay,
a lot.
Okay, go on, Brian.
Bye.
And now the guy who puts on the big hits, Josh Mastrangelo. And Josh, we saw you put on a big special teams hit right on the game, right at the end of the game.
Yeah, well, that was my first time on kickoff for a while there. I was off of it due to an injury, and Coach Mack didn't want to risk me on kickoff. And, you know, they had some good run backs there, and we had to get a guy out of there, get some downfield wedge busters down there, because they were really doing a job on us, blocking and breaking it to the outside. So, you know, we went out there. We knew that we had to hold them deep because they were passing long, you know. They were passing on our reserve cornerback there, you know. He did a great job except for two passes there. Our offense really kept us in the game today. You know, we owe a lot to them. They really, when it came down to it, they sucked it up. You know, they got the 2 points. You know, they got the touchdown without a minute remaining. You know, they kept us in the game today. We played very poorly on defense.
Well, you know, Josh, I'll tell you, from our vantage point, it was difficult to see. But I'll tell you, you guys really stuffed the middle of that line. And Mahopac had a very difficult time running the ball. And I got to believe, even though we weren't able to call it too often, I got to believe number 55 was in the middle of that. Congratulations on a great game.
Thanks.
All right, we'll see you a little later.
Yeah.
And now the guy who made the running tack move, and that's Tom Feliciato. And Tom, a terrific effort. I know centers don't get too much attention, but you had a great game, and we know that.
Thank you. Well, all week, you know, everyone's been saying that all we can do is pass. There's no run offense. Jeffrey did a great job. Brian did a great job. The whole offensive line, Frank Scafani, Joe Smith, Tom Kazakria, and Kevin Wands, and myself. We just came together. The first half, we did great, and then we slowed up. We turned it on in the fourth quarter, and I tell you, it was a great victory.
You're up against a real alley cat in Gerald Caporale. He's pretty good.
Yeah, he was talking. He's a good player. I'm a gamer. I wanted to get him, and I wanted to open up some holes for my running backs, which the whole offensive line did. But he is a good nose guard.
Well, as I said to Brian moments ago, I thought the running attack was the key, and it was spearheaded by you. Congratulations. We'll see you in a bowl game,
thank
okay?
You. Yep, thank you.
All right, Tom. And now, come on over here, Don. You can join me with this. Extraordinary player right here in Frank Heitman. Frank, I thought you were standing by me earlier, but it was Jim McAloon. Congratulations on a great game.
Thank you.
And Don, maybe I'll let you ask the first question.
On the touchdown, the last touchdown that brought you within a point, a post flag pattern?
Yes, post corner it's called. McAloon broke towards the inside and made a cut, went right out to the outside, and he was wide open.
When you saw he was so open, did you hesitate at all to throw the ball?
No, I didn't. I didn't hesitate at all. I knew it was going to him because even if he wasn't that open, I probably would have lobbed it up for him to jump up and get it because he's a great jumper and he has great hands.
And on the extra point, that took a lot of guts. Were you nervous?
Yeah, I was nervous. We never ran that play before at all in practice, but Whitey Breidenbach picked it up from a Florida State game. It's trips right, and two outside guys run posts, and Nick runs more like an angle, and
open.
Yeah, he's wide open. We never had a name for the play, and I was kind of drawing it up on my hands. It was crazy.
You had a super game. You can be very, very proud, because I thought you might be a little tight before the ball game. This is your first Mahopac Carmel game.
Yeah, I was tight the first half. I was like underthrowing passes, throwing behind the receivers. But offensive line did a great job. We ran the ball. We didn't think we were going to run the ball as much as we did. Our offensive line did a great job. Counter traps worked great.
Yes, they did. Your line had a great game, but
yes,
you can be extremely proud of the game you had, too, pal.
Thanks a lot.
I was just going to interject. I've never seen a guy with such poise at the end of the game. Are you always that cool?
No.
Terrific effort, really. Terrific. Well, you have an awful lot to be proud of, and that was a terrific effort down the stretch. And look, I know we're going to see in a bowl game continued success.
Thanks a lot.
All right, Frank Heitman. And we just want to add to our viewers that we tried to get some of the Mahopac players. They declined to come on. Obviously, a very tough loss. They lost by 1 point. They are certainly going to be in a bowl game, maybe even against this same Carmel team. Well, Don, I want to thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you in a couple weeks against Arlington.
It couldn't have been a greater pleasure, Compton. Thank you.
All righty. And, Angelo, we want to thank you very much. All right, and we'll see you maybe in a couple weeks against Arlington.
It's been a pleasure. It was a good game and a good night to watch football.
All right, and that winds it up here from Mahopac High School. We want to thank our entire crew back at the station, Glenn Bisogna, Tony Lentini, and Kevin Bailey here at the site. Paul Rochford, director of the game tonight. Patty Hover and Gene Hallahan working our cameras. For Donald Fries, Angelo Nataro, I'm Compton Spain. Once again, our final from Mahopac High School, Carmel 22, Mahopac 21.